leader is briefly about this. We'll first talk about that kind of assessment models that we developed for four different kinds of students with two different kinds of assessment methods. Afterward, how those competition tests were working on skills evaluation. Well, we were interested, as I said, in the quality of the assessment process and studying that, how could it be afforded, and also how we could improve the objectiveness of the exams, the tests, taking the relevance of questions into account. From that point of view, we were thinking of this kind of assessment. Well, questions are divided into three different levels, maybe three or four, whatever. But the levels are not related to the importance, not to the difficulty, it's to the importance. I mean, level one, in this example, it will contain those questions that are quite, I think it's significant for students. Students studying in computer science should know what does compiling mean. And it's much more important for him, for her, than knowing which is the main characteristic of a recursive function or the objective of the algorithm determinant. So the division takes into account the importance, subjectively, for a student to learn those things. It means that it's much better that this kind of question should be compulsory known. Well, this would be a little bit not so important, and this is something that you can read. So, first point of the approach. Next, the two models we studied are the ones I'm going to show now. In this one, we keep a fixed number of questions per student. This is we can put more questions here or whatever. As you see, in this spot, we have the first level questions there, second level question, third level question. D stands for grades. So grade 6 would be for a student who have correctly answered 6 questions, to level 1, to level 2, to level 3. And now they can move over there. The second model we studied is this one. It's a little more sophisticated and complex. And in fact, it worked worse. Here we were not concerned about a fixed number of questions, but about the difficulty of the question, the significance of the question's answer. So we have a different grades. Those grades, once the student has failed one level questions, we have a grade 0, and the students have moved over there. We can say the number of levels, of course, and the increasement between levels. It means that not all the students would answer the same number of questions. The two first ones are failed, then it's already over. This is our second assumption. Well, for this study, we thought that we could identify 4 different kinds of students. This decision is based on the kind of student we had in the computer science course, and we talk afterwards. We had good students, well, fine. Bad students, it's also easy to understand. But now we have two different kind of students, direct and inverse. Direct for us were the kind of students who concentrate on the most significant of the matter, and well, they forget the rest of the things. And in what we call inverse students are those that the other way around, they look at what is less important, and they study the small things, but forget the basics. What we were trying to see. All these numbers we have here were initial assumptions. All the students for level 1, currently asked 90% of the question, 80% for level 2, and 3, and 7% for 70% for level 3. And well, those are arbitrary numbers. For the simulation I will show now, we have two different kinds of tests for every model. We have the what we call completion test. Completion test is not the word completion, I'm not sure that it's used in, it's commonly used in computer science. But this one alone, when talking about the second language learning, you have to put the word somewhere. That's where the test, the identification or comprehension test. And with their choices, what is this? And then we started the simulation. This is for the modern one, for modern one. The two slides are enough after the one. But we have a fixed number of questions for every kind of students. We say, made a simulation, and in this case that was enough with 10-5 students. But we were looking for the race to convert. So this is really the bad one. The best result we attended, because you can see that the grades are quite different. Inverse students get low grades, because they are not, do not get the things. Direct students get high grades, as well as good students. And bad students are also at this small side, at this lower side. It's the same with two 36 levels with farmers to learn out. This is the 12 level with the where we assume that the 2 out of 3 answers have to be correctly answered per each mode. And the third one is what, the 3 out of 3 correct answers have to be done for each mode. I have good comprehension here. This is with multiple choice test. And as you can see here, things are quite different because when you have multiple choice, we have a kind of statistical model. So it's easier to have, you say, well, you have 3 questions, you have 33% to make a good correct answer with an own about it. And you see, then here our weights shift. Our more inverse students converge in a point where they would pass the exam. But they do not. So this is not so good. For the second model, where we have not a fixed number of questions, but a number depending on what was happening before. We had to make a simulation with 1 million students, because otherwise it did not convert. So in this case, we see that we still get worse results. And we have some double words. We don't know yet, we don't know how to interpret it yet. We have this things where we get a smaller result, it doesn't convert correctly, and some other phenomena, there are some, we do not know how to explain it. Probably we have to work a little bit more. And then, well, this is still more evident in this multiple choice test. You can see that here, a little bit here, a little bit there, but it gets a little more crazy. So for the next, for this experience and showing up, when we talked with the first model and tried to see how it worked in this course. Computer methods of computer methods that is composite course of chemical engineering degree. We had about 100 students, though the results are now showing out, it's only with 30. For different reasons. It had to do with computer science and computer programming with MATLAB. And then we had, this is not important, but I will move this, but I cannot move it. But that is there, so we had theoretical and practical lessons. And this, this is. Sorry, I will raise them. In this experience, we were trying to shift our approach from another point of view. We wanted to see that when we had a classical lesson for the theoretical part and this kind of exam, which were models for the practical lesson, we wanted to see that we could make a coherent, we obtain coherent results. We expected that good students would have good grades in both examinations. And the other way around. This is the kind of test we use as an example where the function was given and they had to modify the parameters so to get different things. In this case, we did also make a different exams for the students. We were changing the data. It made it much more difficult for them to copy. And well, it was not better for us. This is the results we got. Where these are the blue dots are the combination time test, and the others are the results for the other answers, for example, for the theoretical examination. It's not here, but we got with both ways, we got the multiple relation. We had both for Pearson and for Stratton, something 0, 0, 0, 1, and 2. So it's not bad. And it's made me that think of continuing on this, this research area. And at present we are, quite obvious, and what we are doing now is trying to apply this kind of assessment in different areas. Together with the faculty of the humanities of the Universidad Autónoma in the area of archaeology. We have already made some assessments, and well, in a few months we will have some results. And that's what we are making.